Welcome back to Out of the Blue. I'm Andrew Ottman. The Department of Art and Design in the College of Liberal Arts offers students practical experience on a diverse range of platforms and how to use the latest in digital technology. Department Chair Jimmy Mumford joins us to talk about the work of his students and faculty colleagues. Jimmy, welcome to Out of the Blue.
Thank you for having me.
Glad to have you on the program, first time. You've been on campus for about a year. So let's give viewers the first story. Talk about your department, Art and Design, and what you try to achieve and deliver to students.
So in the Department of Art and Design, if you talk about the faculty and staff, we have 30 total people. Mm-hmm. We have a number of degrees, which range from BFA, which is Bachelor of Fine Arts, BA, which is a Bachelor of Arts, mm-hmm. and a BS degree. So those degrees are graphic design, studio, there's an illustration through graphic design, there's also interaction. We also have art education, mm-hmm. And visual arts. So those are the degrees that we have in the Department of Art and Design.
Wonderful. And you're over in the Todd building. I visit there quite frequently. I believe you are among many who maintain the Todd Art Gallery, which is a pride point for the university. Is that true?
That's true. You know, the Todd Art Gallery is used for a number of activities. Primarily, of course, we do a great job with the community. Mm-hmm. So we also give students an opportunity to show their work. Mm-hmm. We have the Saturday at Todd's that occurs every other Saturday with a number of events from drawing to teaching the community ceramics. There's tie-dye t-shirts, there's marbling. So those are some of the things that we do with the Saturdays at Todd.
And I'm struck when I visit Todd and I see the work of your department is the diversity of not only the work that's put forward, but also the faculty and the students. You've got to be proud of everything you're putting forth and the people who are helping you do this.
I am. That's one of the strengths of the department is the diversity, not only among the students, but among the faculty and the diverse disciplines that everyone offers. Of course, myself, I'm a graphic designer. I'm a practitioner. You have a lot of artists, of course, in the department who not only just teach, but they're practitioners in their field. So they give students real world experience. Mm-hmm. One of the things that's to our strength as well is that we like to keep up with what's current. So as you know, graphic design is always evolving, or arts is always evolving. So we have to evolve with the trends and everything and make sure we keep up so that when we're teaching students, when they leave here, we're keeping them current with industry standards.
And that means the latest in technology, but also the basics behind the technology, correct? All of the ways that you can express yourself.
That's correct. So you talk about technology, there is the Adobe Creative Suite, you know, that can range anywhere from Adobe Illustrator to Adobe Photoshop. And now, of course, now, with the evolution of AI, which are being introduced into the software, it's giving students a different way to express themselves and to do things. So we have to make sure that we stay on top of those and know how to teach our students those nuances every time something happens or change in the software.
Well, let me ask you about yourself, because you mentioned you're a practitioner. And talk about the work that you do to keep current in the field and contribute to things outside of the university.
Okay, so I teach graphic design, and of course, I'm always in the field. So I have clients. People call up all the time wanting a variety of things, from posters to logos to websites. So instead of me actually reading a book and standing in front of class trying to teach the students what I read in the book, I can teach them what I know that's going to work. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, the experience is the best teacher.
So thank you for sending us some examples of your student work. Can you talk through them as we're showing it to our audience on television?
So the work that we have, or the courses that we teach a variety of courses. So some of the work may be graphic design. It also may be illustration. There's sculpture, there's ceramics, there's drawing, and there's also painting.
Wonderful, wonderful. And we appreciate being able to showcase the work of those students. Talk to me about what I need to do as a prospective student to prepare myself to be part of your department. Are there things in high school or work I should be bringing to you and doing before I apply?
Sometimes it can depend. Of course, it can depend on your interest. So if you are interested in illustration, mm-hmm. then of course what we'd be looking for would be illustration work. If you're interested in graphic design, then we want to see the posters, we want to see those logos, we want to see those newsletters. If you're interested in painting, then we want to see the painting that you've done in oil, a painting that you created in acrylic. So all these things become important. We also have a number of scholarships that we offer students throughout the year. So the portfolio becomes even more critical because it allows us to look at your work, examine it, and see which scholarship appropriately applies to what you're applying for.
Wonderful. Mm-hmm. We mentioned that you've been here for about a year. Talk about your impressions on campus and the department. Has it been I hope it's been a good first year, and I hope you're looking for a even better second year.
It's been a great first year. You know, the thing about what I enjoy about the department is the diversity of faculty and the diversity of skill set. One of the things that we're always trying to teach the students is you have to be able to understand that there's a difference between one who looks and one who sees. So how can you show me something in a different way? So for instance, I can take this sheet of paper and turn it into an origami. Or I can also take this sheet of paper, and if I tape it, if I'm a homeless person, I'm using it to cover myself. So how can you force me to see something different? Critical thinking, of course, is important in graphic design. Many people think art, they think that you just sit outside and draw and paint. Well, that may be partly true, but what you're drawing or what you're painting or do you understand what you're doing is what people are looking for.
Wow. Jimmy, you also wanted to pass along a kind of a pro tip about some prefix changes and how we identify courses. Can you talk through those real fast?
Yeah, so recently we went through the curriculum committee. We've updated a bunch of courses through the Department of Art and Design. So in addition to the ART prefix, we've added three new prefixes, which are DGSN, which is graphic design, ILLU, which is illustration, and IDX, which is interaction design.
So if I'm trying to find those courses, maybe I saw them before under ART, they're now separated by these prefixes.
That's correct.
Professor, if I want to find out more information about your program, where do I go?
If you want to find out more information, you can go to mtsu.edu/art.
Well, Professor Jimmy Mumford of the Department of Art and Design in the College of Liberal Arts, thank you so much for joining us on Out of the Blue.
Thank you for having me.